Hey, guess what? You've got mail from Miss Powell. Thank you for allowing me to come into your classroom and learn with you. It has been so much fun. You will have a great time in kindergarten next year. I miss you. Have a good summer. Sincerely, Miss Powell.
Hey, what's up, everyone? If you are new here, my name is Crochet. I will begin teaching in the fall. Right now, I am in the hiring process for a first grade teaching position. So go ahead and click that subscribe button so that you can follow along with my teaching journey. Today, I am going to show you guys how to create a digital letter that you can send out to your students through Seesaw, through Classroom Dojo, or whatever platform that you use to communicate with your parents and your students. This video was inspired by a teacher tuber by the name of Shakira. Her YouTube channel is called Saved by the Bell. I will go ahead and link her information in the description box. She's so stinking cute, y'all. Okay, so the first thing you'll do is go ahead and open up PowerPoint and open a blank presentation. You can click here to clear the title and type "you got mail from." Okay, so I'm currently editing the video and I noticed that I put "you got mail" instead of "you've got mail." So I went ahead and fixed it, but make sure that you fix that. Go ahead and change the font to your desired font. I've been really in love with this font lately, so that's why I chose this one. You can move it up a little bit, just like that. And then down here, you'll type Miss or Mr., whoever you are. Powell, my Mrs. Powell. And then I want to change it in some sort of cursive font. I'm going to make it as loose as possible, or what am I doing? Possible. Move it up. Fold it. Make it a little bit bigger. And it'll look like that. I really want to change this color, but I don't know what to change it to. So I guess I'll just leave it black. You got mail from Miss Powell. From Miss Powell. My pre-K kids call me Miss Powers. Let's make it of this a little bit bigger. Okay. So you got mail from Miss Powell. And then you're going to go ahead and create the letter. So you will insert a shape and you'll make a rectangle for your letter. Make sure it's centered. Okay, so then for the background, you want your background to be white, or that's the outline, sorry. So you want your background to be white, you want your outline to be black, and then you can change the weight to 6, so it can be a little bit bolder, just like that. And then now you're gonna go ahead and add a triangle. And you want it to be inside of the rectangle and you wanna make it in there just like that. So you'll do the same thing. You want the shape fill to be white. You want your outline to be black and you want to change the weight to 6. And so you see how down here it looks weird. You are going to make sure that it fits perfectly inside, just like that. So then you'll click the triangle and you'll copy it and you're going to paste it and turn it around upside down and put it at the top. Again, make sure that it fits in perfectly, just like that. And so this is your letter. A girl who I got this idea from, her name is Shakira. She added a cute little heart up here. So I'm going to go ahead and add a heart because it was just too cute and I just had to put it there. So cute. So I want my color to be like a pink, but I want like a light pink. Yeah, like a bubble gum. So then I don't want an outline, so it looks like that. That's so cute, y'all. Okay, so now we are going to add some animations. So now you're going to go ahead and click on each shape. So you'll click on both triangles, the rectangle, and the heart. So if you move it around, it all moves together. And then you're going to click, this little group section, and you'll click group. So now that when we move it around, it's all together. And so now we're going to add our animation. So you click on the letter, go up here to animations, and you'll choose bounce so that it can bounce in. You can include your own. So like if you want to do like the curve, you can do whatever you want to do. Oh, you want to know what? I think the pinwheel is cuter. Yeah, so I'll do the pinwheel. So you can add that, and then you'll add a second animation, and I really like the teeter. This is what Shakira did as well. When the students open the video or click on the video, it'll look like this, and I'll do the little teeter. So stinking cute. So you can do any like animation that you want, but I chose the pinwheel and the teeter. So now we are going to do our actual letter. So you'll open a new slide. You'll delete these. You'll insert a new shape, and you'll go and do your square again. So we're making another letter, but this time it's going to look like the letter is open. Same old thing, white background. I'm gonna do a black outline, make the weight 6, and it'll look just like that. Same old thing. You're going to go and add a triangle. White background, black outline, make the weight 6. You know what? I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger. And you'll just do it like that. Make sure it fits in perfectly. Your girl is on the struggle bus today. Okay, so then you'll go ahead and copy the triangle. Oh, you'll go ahead and copy the triangle, and you will paste it. Okay, so then you'll bring it to the top. But this time it'll look like the letter is open, so you won't flip it upside down. And just adjust it so that it looks like it's perfectly in there. Like that. And so now you're going to go ahead and add another shape. You're going to add another rectangle, and this is your letter. Okay, so same old thing, white background with your black outline, make the weight 6, just like that. So stinking cute. Okay, so now what Shakira did was she created her own like Polaroid frame. So you'll go ahead and add another square here to the side, and you'll turn it that way, or you can leave it straight, whatever you want to do, it's your preference. Make that a little skinnier, just like that. White background, black outline, but this time I'm going to do a 2 1/4 for the 2 1/4 for the weight. I'm going to copy that. I'm going to copy that and make this smaller so that it fits inside, so it gives it that polar weight. Y'all, it's so funny because like I'm just noticed my head's tilting. That's funny because this is tilted, so I'm like, I'm so weird. If you do that, comment below so that I won't just feel weird. Okay, so it'll look just like that. And you can write like a cute little note here, or you can add like anything else. I'm going to add the same super cute heart. Oh, I can't do it. Sorry. I'm going to add the same super cute heart. So we'll do it like that. I'll make it pink with no outline and turn it like this. Just like that. And so now I'm gonna do something a little different. I'm going to for this square, I'm going to make the fill no fill, and I'm doing this so that when I add my picture, it can be at the back of this. I'll show you. So just click that and make the shape fill no fill, and then now I'm going to add my picture. And so I'm going to add this picture, so I'll drag it in. I'm going to crop it some, so I'll go here and crop it the best way I can so that it can fit. So now I'm going to do my letter. So you'll go ahead and insert a text box and put it up here, and you'll type dear student. Of course, right there you will type your student's name, but for confidentiality purposes, I don't want to put their name there. So I'll click, so I'll just put dear student, and so it'll look like that.
Okay, so this is how it looks. I'm kind of annoyed because right here it's not a cute, like there's nothing there. So I'm gonna go find something cute to put down there. I found this cute XOXO for a hugs and kisses. So I went ahead and grabbed that. Oh, that's not the transparent one. This is the one. So I'm gonna add this at the bottom. So this is the letter, and now I'm going to add audio. You can add audio if you want. I personally want to add audio because these are pre-K kids. And I want them to hear my excitement. So you'll click insert over here, you'll click audio. You can either record an audio or you can add in audio files. I'll just click record audio. And click record, and it's literally just recording my audio. So I'll type digital letter for pre-K and click insert. And so here's a little icon. I'm just gonna put it down here at the bottom, make it a little bit smaller, and make it a little bit smaller, and then up here where it says playback, click that and make sure that it automatically plays. And if it, right here where it says play across slides, be sure that that's not there, like that's unchecked, because you only want it to play once it gets to the screen. So this is how it looks, and I'm going to go ahead and save it. So I'll click file, export, digital letter for pre-K. And I want to save it as a movie file, and I'll click export, and that's it. By the way, guys, I went ahead and added some audio to the beginning of the letter so that when they opened it, it wouldn't be that awkward silence.
Hey, guess what? You've got mail from Miss Towel. Thank you for allowing me to come into your classroom and learn with you. It has been so much fun. You will have a great time in kindergarten next year. I miss you. Have a good summer. Sincerely, Miss Powell.
Okay, guys, so that's an example of the digital letter that I will be sending to my pre-K kids. I am also going to send letters to my third grade kids where I student taught in as well. I did half and half, half pre-K, half third grade. So obviously I may not do the audio with the third graders. I will just allow them to read it. But you know what? No, I'm going to go ahead and do the audio because I want them to be able to hear my voice. I miss them so, so much, y'all. If you are new here, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Give this video a thumbs up if you have enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.